In the last episode, I said a disclaimer that I have been repeating throughout the whole process of the Marble Machine X build. I said that I hadn't adjusted the timing of the Marble Machine X, which is true, and I said that it will play much better than this. But in my ears, this disclaimer is sounding more and more like an apology, or like I'm trying to hide something. I have decided that it is time for me to stop using this disclaimer, and I want to investigate once and for all how tight can I make this machine play. In order to investigate how tight the Marble Machine X can play, we need the metronome of the Marble Machine X to work correctly. And this is where the mechanical rhythm machine comes in. The mechanical rhythm machine is like a metronome click, like click, 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 click. 1, 2, 3, 4. And by making this properly, I can then time the whole machine to this click, and perhaps we can reach my life goal of stop using this apology once and for all. The musical function of the rhythm machine is to play fast enough so it can add the subdivision to the beat. The Marble Machine X has a kick drum, a snare drum, and a hi-hat. And this trio can play a normal beat. Right? And then maybe often, to make it sound professional in production, you add a shaker. This mechanical rhythm machine is the shaker of the Marble Machine X. The first thing I built was a circular timing disc with the four channels that plays on whole notes, half notes, sixteenths, and triplets. And these were really fun to machine, and I thought they looked really, really cool, kind of a little futuristic space station-like. So when that was done, I tested the rhythms just with some foam parts.
Offbeat bell.
The concept of the rhythm machine seems great. Now I need to make things that actually make the sound. First, I needed to improve the beaters. The previous version was from mild steel, and as you can see here, they got bent, so I changed to spring steel. Once the spring steel was on the machine, we could start to make the levers, and I got help from one of the MMX 18 engineers, Toby, from tobiasgutman.de. Toby made the four metal levers. Toby also brought laser cut felt washers that he had made. I could use them to eliminate mechanical sounds between the Marble Machine X and these rhythm levers. Felt bushing, kinda cool. I also used felt as liner for these slots for the levers. It both keep the lever in position and isolate the mechanical sound again. There is not a single point where the metal of the levers touch the metal of the machine.
So this is actually a four channel volume mixer. You increase the volume on channel 2. I am really stoked out how this feels.
To cut a radius in the corner, you can use a drill bit and drill a hole, and then use that same drill bit as a pivot point and rotate your workpiece around and let the grinder take off the corner. This radius will be concentric to your hole. Apart from the heating of the piece there, it looks really good.
These are the soundboards for the mechanical rhythm machine. As you see on the top, they have a slightly different form, and this will actually produce the envelope of the sound. So this is for the whole note, shoof. This is for the whole note, shh-tush. This is for the 16th, tick. And this is for the triplet, tick. So fun finally getting the rhythm machine in condition.
Part of the reason the Marble Machine is taking so long time is that there are a lot of sub-assemblies like this with a lot of parts. I'm gonna show you how one of these channels goes together. Four Erlund preamps, four EAP pickups. And I'm gonna take the first one. I'm gonna take some tacket. The mic should only touch any surface through the tacket. So I don't want any wood or any washer to be in contact with the black part of the microphone.
That looks legit.
Custom laser cut felt washers from Toby. These felt washers are here to isolate the contact microphone from the metal lever.
These are adjustable back and forth for timing. So these are cable holders with felt inside to keep the cable controlled and away from the mechanical noise. And I made them with my favorite trick splitter design in the middle. And then you have two holes like this. Here we go. I'm recording this to the computer. Okay, so here's the whole note, here's the offbeat, here's the 16th, and together, let's hear the triplets as well down here, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, so nothing is tweaked sound wise at this moment, and it's time to start to make this sound really great. So let's start with the whole note. So this is the soundboard, the sound curve of the whole note. That's a longer sound. So the idea is to let this sound tongue be engaged longer and make a swoosh. Like that. But I think this curve is wrong. I think I want this curve to engage much earlier up here. This is how the tongue is traveling, and I'm going to add some wood here to increase the build up to the peak of the sound. I'm going to rug this surface up with coarse sandpaper for a little bit of a cucumber effect, if you know the music instrument cucumber. First one, third one. I actually like the first one best. We're not there yet. If we compare to my favorite so far, test one. I think we're getting there, but I wanna try something else. Test 5, I flipped it 180 degrees, so the straight part is on the out feed. So here's the first, second, third, fourth, that's pretty good as well, fifth, and sixth and current.
The leaves are already falling. We can't ignore the truth anymore. We have to put our differences aside, whether you like the kinetic fingers or not. We have to prepare together. Because... that's right, winter is coming. You asked us to make an I Believe hoodie, so we did. I'm really happy that you asked and that we did, because it's really, really, really cozy. So far the quality is great. I haven't washed it yet, so I can't speak after the first wash. I'm doing a great job selling this hoodie. Anyway, the hoodie comes in two designs, with I Believe on the front and the machine on the back, like this. Can you see it? And we also made a Stealth Believer design with only the I Believe etched on top of your heart, with no machine on the back, if you like a more minimalistic design. To be prepared for the coming onslaught of cold-blooded design failures, check out the hoodie at teespring.com/store/wintergatan, where we also have the I Believe poster and the I Believe t-shirt. That's it, hope you like the hoodie, and thank you so much for your support. Let's check out if we can fix that rhythm machine.
So I'm going to try to play the rhythm machine tight with the drum beat from the computer. It's kind of difficult to play the marble machine next to a click. I need to practice that a lot. You can hear I'm starting with the first channel and trying to get that in sync. It takes a while to find the tempo, and then I add the second channel. I I think this sounds awful. The rhythm is really, really difficult to get really tight. Let's add the 16th, third channel. So there are some moments when I'm managing to play tight, but the tempo is going up and down all the time. Triplets. And let's mute the offbeats and the 16ths to hear the triplets better. You can hear how I'm like floating in and out of timing. It's really tricky to control the flywheel and play tight to the click. Listen to the sound when I slow down the machine at the end. It sounds like the rhythm machine is laughing at me.
So there's two different issues here. The timing is one issue and the sound is another issue. So let's try to separate these and forget about the timing for now. I don't like the sound. I can like tweak this. It just sounds like spring steel scraping on a piece of plywood with a contact microphone, kind of like that. Like that. I don't like it. And also this shoo, 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 which is a super cool idea. For example, in the Marble Machine X Play drum video, I'm adding these sounds. I think I'm adding the 16th here. Taka 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 taka. So when I'm watching this machine and I'm hearing taka 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 taka, I don't feel it. Plus the fact that the envelope of these longer sounds, if we zoom in really far here, the upper here is an offbeat. And this is a hi-hat. And as you can see, the hi-hat has like a clear transient. And in the offbeat, we can kind of choose where the rhythm center is lying. So I could kind of slide this back and forward on the beat. It has like a kind of uncertainty built into the sound itself of where its rhythmic center is. We have yet another problem with these. So these sounds are designed to work with the audio gate. The gate has a threshold value which opens and lets the high signal through and the low signals not through. So the background noise here can be shut off with the gate. The gate is closing off all the background noise and only lets through the peaks. But since I'm having this volume feature where I'm raising the lever, the threshold value is a little bit, I want it like sweet spot for this volume, but then the gate will kill these. You hear, you don't even hear them. So if I go down with the threshold until we hear these, that's maybe not my favorite threshold value for this. So this whole volume idea is also a little bit bad. I'm thinking it might be better that I just have on or off. I don't like it. I'm kind of surprised that I didn't prototype this sound before I built the whole thing on the Marble Machine X. Like, I was over prototyping everything in the whole process up until now, where I just invested so much time into building this and just I took for granted that I would like the sound. I think I know what to do.
I could improve a lot on these sounds with plugins, but it's like when you become good at cooking, you want really good ingredients to work with. The more I work with audio engineering, I feel bad things in equals bad things out. It's a little bit like this beginner attitude when you're sound checking a band and it sounds horrible and everyone says it will sound better when the audience comes. It's often true, but it's also often not true. Instead of like try to polish the surface on something corrupt, I feel like switching out what is corrupt and doing it good from the beginning. There's a famous trap in designing anything that's called feature creep, and that's when you keep on adding new functions. This redesign that I'm now embarking on has a little bit smell of feature creep, but it's also a little bit smell of amazing also. This is the excuses someone makes when they're in the middle of a feature creep denial. But anyway, I think you can relate to the fact of the bad things in, bad things out. I was just naive about the sound source, and the fact is, that I've discovered something really exciting to replace it with. And I learned so much in this process. So a year ago, I was a so much more naive designer than I am today.
The actual bloodstain is just finishing off the scene perfectly, isn't it?
Like a year ago, I thought everything was fixable. Like, we have a cool idea, we can tweak it at the end. Nowadays, I am much more restrictive, I'm much more critical, I'm much less naive. And I'm like, the idea has to be good in the foundation, which is the big joke on this whole marble machine, because playing music with marbles is a first principle bad idea. That's what I'm fighting against. So far, I think the best value that has come out of this playing music with marbles idea is for you to see someone fighting their guts out to perform a perhaps impossible dream. And I mean, that's a great value. I just hope we can add nice music on top, like at the side, slip in also. Just this facepalm engineering entertainment value. I love to deliver that, but I also would love to deliver some sweet music that you can't stop listening to in your car without like watching the marble machine. This ability I have to go back and redo things without remorse is like almost symbolized by the angle grinder at this moment, isn't it? But this ability I have is a double-edged sword. It's also a downfall for me because it's a huge risk of me getting stuck, always tweaking, always improving. The fundamental reason for me that this redesign is a no-brainer is because I found out a really, really, really good replacement solution that I just love.
Here you can see one of the issues with this design, that the spring steel gets bent like this. And of course, a bent spring steel will not have the correct timing.
Let me introduce to you the Hihat Machine. This Hihat Machine solves a lot of issues. Instead of four different sound sources, it's one sound source. It has only on and off for each sound channel. It doesn't have a volume increase, so we can put the gate threshold at a sweet spot. The drumsticks are made with a spring and they won't deflect after some time like the spring steel does. And most of all, you will understand where the sound is coming from with. And best of all, the drummer of the Marble Machine X has suddenly improved the hi-hat skills of its playing profoundly. So we have a drummer that can play really, really, really good hi-hat, and we can mix the two hi-hats and create this really funky, funky feeling. Listen to this drum beat I made with only offbeat hi-hat. And then we introduce 16th hi-hat on top of that. Listen how the flow starts. This is what I think the Hi-Hat Machine will be able to do for the Marble Machine X. It was especially when I was mixing the Marble Machine X placed drums that I didn't find a lot of joy, I didn't find good placements for the rhythm machine sounds, and this is just going to be mixed like a hi-hat. So the Marble Machine becomes more and more a trio, the bass player, the drummer, and the vibraphone player. It's purified, it's simplified. I love it. In this episode, I'm going to start to shape the hi-hat, and then we're gonna finish this build in the next episode. I wasn't able to stop using my disclaimer about Marble Machine X tightness in this episode. I have to wait hopefully only one more week to reach that life goal, and you have to wait as well with me. Anyway, thank you so much for following this iterative process. I wanna say a special thanks to everyone who are supporting this through YouTube channel memberships and Patreon. You are making it possible for me to follow my dream. Every week we have so many new backers, a special welcome to you. Building the Marble Machine X is sometimes a lonely project, but not anymore. So many new backers are coming in each week, and you are together with me pushing this stone up the Sisyphus hillside. Thanks to your support, I can get more help around me, and I can do this absolutely crazy, super high, what will be high level engineering project. So thank you all for watching, good luck with everything you are doing, and I'll see you on the next Wintergatan Wednesdays.